My body is perfect, healthy, always. If there is any ailment, any parameter which is not normal, you put a specific thought for that. My sugar levels are normal. Give the figure there which you want, not the figure which is right now in the blood report. If there is any karmic account relationship which is not good, take that person's name and say, there and my relationship is beautiful. Past karmic account is over. So even if a situation is tough, first take care of the mind. If the mind is taken care of, the body will be safe. If the mind and body is fine, relationships will okay. We'll handle the karmic account. Say this every morning. And say this or write this every night before going to sleep. It will take less than 1 minute. Huh? But within 15-20 days, you will see your thoughts changing. Because now you're coding a different thought. So let's write a few thoughts right now, or you can record it on your phone, which will be our new karma balls that we are going to throw. They are going to be our new karma balls that we are going to throw. They are going to be for my nature, that is for my sanskar, for the health of my body, for my relationships, for my work, and for my destiny. So my first karma ball, my first thought is, I am a powerful soul. I am a powerful soul. Which means whatever may be the situation, I respond with power. I don't react. I am a powerful soul. Second, I am calm and stable always. I am calm and stable always. Third, I am always happy. I am always happy. Fourth, I am fearless. I am confident. I am fearless. I am confident. Fifth, you will choose any one sanskar of yours and you will write the sankalp for that. The vocabulary is very important. Not to use the negative word. Not to say, I don't want to be like this. Say, I am, and put that positive quality there. Suppose somebody takes time to take decisions. They're not able to take decisions quickly. They keep asking other people, what should I do? Then they, what sankalp will they put? You share? Now you should know this vocabulary. It's very simple. What sankalp will they put? I am going to take what? I am going to take the decision. Change. One step higher. My every decision is quick and always accurate. I take quick decisions and accurate decisions always. Some people are not able to say no to people. Find very difficult to say no. We don't need to say no if we don't have to say no. But sometimes just suppressing and not saying no becomes very difficult. So then put a sankalp. I say no respectfully and with dignity. Some people are always late. Sanskar. So what will be the sankalp? What will be the new karma ball? I'm always before time. Go higher in the blessing. So this is blessings that we're sending to ourselves to change our karma. So now this is the language. Learn the language. It's very easy. This will is going to help all your life. And it's not just going to help you. You will be able to create sankalp for other people and give them. What is the vocabulary? What we want to see, we have to say it already is now, and high vibrational words. Sixth, my body is perfect, healthy, always. My body is perfect, healthy, always. If there is any ailment, any parameter which is not normal, you put a specific thought for that. My sugar levels are normal. Give the figure there which you want, not the figure which is right now in the blood report. So I am saying, what is my new karma ball saying? My sugar levels are normal. Fill in the blank, put the figure. I am sending that karma to the body. If my knee is paining, I will say my knee is perfect. I am running. Then next sankalp for our relationships. I accept people, people accept me, and all my relationships are strong. My family is united. If there is any karmic account relationship which is not good, take that person's name and say, there and my relationship is beautiful. Past karmic account is over. If someone, like sometimes children are not respectful, they are not caring, they're very busy in their own world, send a sankalp to them. I respect you, you respect me. Don't go and tell them you don't respect me. Don't. That will be a negative ball that will go there. Just throw a thought, you respect me. Sometimes children don't have time for us. Don't go and tell them you don't have time for us. Throw the thought, you have a lot of time for me. Whatever you want to see in reality, start sending the thoughts to them. Talking from here only creates more entanglement. But sending a thought, and the most powerful time to send someone a thought is when they are sleeping. Because that time their catching power is higher. That is why you see what a parent does with the child. When the child is sleeping, the parent just keeps doing this on the forehead and saying some nice prayer, some nice song, because it's going to go into the consciousness of the child when the child is sleeping. So the parent says high vibrational words sitting over there like that. So when somebody is awake, a lot of thoughts on their mind. When they're sleeping, their mind is silent, send it, they catch faster. And then one sankalp for what we do, for our work. Whatever you want to achieve, whatever you want to become, you create a thought, I am already that. I have already achieved that. That thing is already ready. Sometimes during COVID, people borrowed money from us, they have not yet returned it, and we keep thinking they are not giving, they are not giving, they are not giving. What will happen if we keep sending the ball, they are not giving? They will not give. Very good. Now master this language. This will change life. Now what's going to be the sankalp? Change the sankalp. See, it is so easy, right? Next time you can sit here and give. I don't have to come also. This is so easy. This is so easy. It's very, very easy. Just send them that energy. I understand you. I understand that there is something happened in your life. But you know what? I am certain. You have already returned my money. Send them lot of love. Send them lot of blessings. First thing, what will happen? My stress and all that fear is over. You know, at the end of the day, even if the money doesn't come back, 1% chance, my mind and body will remain healthy. If my mind and body is healthy, I'll earn lot of money in my lifetime. But if my mind creates that stress, my blood pressure increases, I get irritable at home, money though doesn't come, but happiness, health and relationship also gets affected. So one was a past karmic account, money didn't come. Three rest karmas I create in my present and make my life difficult. So even if a situation is tough, first take care of the mind. If the mind is taken care of, the body will be safe. If the mind and body is fine, relationships will okay, we'll handle the karmic account. So whatever is the vocabulary, so don't say you're not giving, you're not doing, just send a thought, you are, I have already got it. Even say thank you to them in your mind, thank you so much for returning my money. You know what happens? Your thoughts reach the other person. And suddenly the person creates a thought, chalo yaar, I might as well return that money. Even they don't know why they're creating that thought. But if we keep sending the thought, they're not giving, they're not giving, they're not giving, they're not giving. So even if they were planning to give that day, but in the morning while having your tea, you and your wife are saying, they are not giving. wife is saying maybe they will never give. Then you are saying maybe I'll never get this money back. That day that person had decided to come and give it. But we sent so many blessings. So then that person says, forget, I might need this money, I'll see next year. Bye bye. Our thoughts reach people. Haven't you ever experienced that you were about to call up somebody, they called you? Haven't you ever experienced you were going to ask somebody something, they answer you before they asked? How is it happening? Thoughts reach people faster than words and behavior. So just send them the thoughts which you want to see in reality, and success is certain for me. Always say this, success is certain for me. Don't say, I want to be successful. Don't say, my children should be successful. Say, success is certain for them. Don't say, my children don't study. What will happen if you keep saying, my children don't study? Every day you don't study, and then we don't think, we say also. So double karma. So even if they are not studying, what is the energy that I have to keep sending to them? You are studying beyond your capacity. Success is certain for you. Blessings. Do blessings work? Do blessings work? We go and ask other people to bless us. We go and ask other people to bless our children. We have to start learning to create our blessings, not once in a while, making our vocabulary a blessing. Everything we think and speak will be a blessing. And the last sankalp will be, God's power and blessings is a divine circle of protection around me. Draw a white divine circle energy around yourself. There are a lot of vibrations around us of a lot of people. So protect yourself with that. That God's power and blessings is a divine circle of protection around me. So I'm a powerful soul. I'm calm and stable always. I'm always happy. I'm fearless, confident. Fifth one is whichever I select for myself. Sixth one is my body is perfect, healthy. Whatever you want to see in that body, say it. It has already happened. I am doing that perfectly fine. Then people accept me. I accept them. All my relationships are strong. I forgive, I forget. Past karmic account is over. Success is certain for me. And God's power and blessings is a divine circle of protection around me. Can we write out these 10 thoughts after we go home? Can we write out? These are our conscious present karma, which is a white ball. Now, say this every morning. And say this or write this every night before going to sleep. It will take less than 1 minute, huh? But within 15-20 days, you will see your thoughts changing. Because now you're coding a different thought. So first step is to start stopping my other thoughts, which seemed very right thoughts. So every night before going to sleep, can we write it out? Keep a diary pen near your pillow only for this. Date, sankalp, date, sankalp, date, sankalp. Keep repeating it till it becomes a reality. Keep repeating it till it becomes a reality. And morning, first thought, gratitude to God, gratitude to my mind and body, gratitude to people, and then my 10 thoughts. First thoughts before I start to think about what to do today, what to cook, what to do, no. Because subconscious mind is very powerful in the night and in the morning. So I need to put the seed that time. Can we do that morning and night? Very easy. And third time, which is very powerful, is with food and water. Sometimes while eating, we discuss problems. And if we are not discussing, it's on our mind. It will just go. We've always learned that before we eat, what should we do? Take a minute and pray. Why should we pray before eating? So that we radiate high energy to the food, because jaisa ann, vaisa man. As is the vibration of the food, so is the vibration of my mind. So please add your sankalp to your food and water. That is your personal prayer. Add your sankalp to your food and water, because the food and water has lot of people's sankalp in it. Your food is carrying thoughts of how many people? The food that you will eat today for lunch is carrying the sankalp of how many people? First the farmer. then the air which is around the crop is from the city. So people's thoughts. Then it's coming to the market. Then it's coming to the shop. Then the person who is cooking. And then the last, the person who is serving. And then if you eat with TV, then everyone which is screaming across the TV screen, that is also gone. So one most important thing, never eat with TV and phone. We were supposed to eat in a silent manner with a little prayer. It is very important to eat with the right energy. No discussing problems while eating. No telling another person while eating, you should not eat this. You want to say it? Say before or say after. Don't say it into the food. This will be not good for your body. Don't bless that food like that. And even while eating yourself, don't say, I know this is not good, but I'm eating. I know I should not eat mithai, but I'm eating. I know my sugar level will increase, but I'm eating. Either don't eat, either while eating, I'll say, no, this is prasad for me. It's not going to do anything good. Don't give negative thought to the food. It becomes very powerful. That is why prasad is so important, because prasad is high vibrational energy into the food and water. So make your food and water prasad. Make it amrit by putting high vibration food. One, while cooking, and second, while eating. So while cooking, have high energy words playing in the kitchen. Can we do it? Can we cook like we cook in a temple? Can we cook like we cook the day we are making prasad? We take care physically. We have a bath, we clean the kitchen, everything. Take care, mind is clean while cooking. So how many of you cook at home? Clean, peaceful mind, saying your prayer, meditating, saying your mantra, do it while cooking. It will change the destiny of the family. And most important, the rest of you should take care that you keep that person of the house who cooks very happy. Because if they are upset or hurt, it is going to come back to you in your idli and dosa. They'll go into the kitchen in that pain, cook for you, and they will come back and it'll go to you. Very important role of the person who cooks for the family. So have high energy words playing in the kitchen. Like how in the temple, how prasad is cooked. Prayers and hymns are playing in that kitchen. We can play it in our house. Please do this. It's a very simple thing, but it creates magical result. And then just before eating, 10-second pause, gratitude, and say your sankalp to the food and water. I'm powerful, I'm healthy, everything is perfect. Destiny is safe.